getting ready to have my pre-workout, and then I'm gonna go get my first day of my new workout program done. I'm not turning on the lights because it's still pretty early. So I've got my water. Not normal for me to be awake this early. Okay, here we go. Oakley's awake. Okay, this is my work outfit for the day. This top is from Zaya, and the leggings are from Amazon, and they're super, super soft and comfortable. And all of my clothes that I wear, my workout clothes, everything that I share in my videos, you can find links in my link tree down below. These leggings are saved under my favorite Amazon clothes. And I think they're saved under holiday leggings. They have like Christmas ones, Halloween ones. They have all kinds of really cool designs. So they're really, really comfortable. I'm in the basement in our workout room. Today is day one of my new workout program. The program I'm doing is called Fire and Flow, and it is a Beachbody program. So at any point, if you see my workouts and you're interested in joining me with this program, I will put a link down below to access the Beachbody On Demand entire workout library. And so there are a lot of different choices when it comes to the membership. You do not need to do any of the expensive challenge packs that have supplements and all that stuff. You just scroll through until you see the digital only membership. And that is just the online membership to Beachbody On Demand. It's the cheapest version. If you get the annual membership, it ends up being like $10 a month. So, and then all year long, you have access to like hundreds of different workout programs. So that's why I'm starting today. And so my usual routine is I do my workout and then I sit in the sauna. So that is our sauna right there. We got that on Amazon, and I do have a link for that saved in my link tree down below. But here's my setup. I've got my weights here, got the TV where I'll play my Beachbody On Demand workout. With Beachbody On Demand, you can play your workouts on your smartphone, on your computer, or if you have a TV device like a Roku, a Fire Stick, an Apple TV, then you can hook it up to your TV and then you can stream the workouts on your TV. So I'm excited to get started. Okay, so here is what things look like when I pull it up on my TV. So if I go back, there's a whole library, excuse me. There's a whole library of different workouts that you can do. And so this is the one that I am doing, Fire and Flow. So I just click on that, and then it tells you a little bit about the program. Alternates strength and cardio days with low impact body shaping recovery days. Basically you need dumbbells, resistance loops, and a mat. The workouts are 25 to 30 minutes a day, which I like because I don't like to do long workouts. And so then, I just go over to the side and I'm on week one. And so I'm going to get started. Okay, so I forgot to mention that I do have they give you a printable workout calendar. So This is my workout calendar for the next 4 weeks, and it just tells you which workout you're supposed to do, which it also tells you on here, so you can't go wrong. Okay, so that was my first day of my new program. It was upper body. I really enjoyed it. I am having a lot of issues with low back pain right now. I'm not really sure what's causing it, but it's a little frustrating. So I have to modify some of the exercises. And normally I am not a person who stretches. I usually skip the stretching, but I am doing the stretching now just because I think that it might help with my low back pain. So anyway, my workout is done. I sat in the sauna for 30 minutes. I am going to go shower. I'm going to get dressed, and then I'm going to get me a cup of black coffee and start my work day. So for those of you who are new here, I work from home. It's a full-time job, so it's like all day long. I sit at a desk, I write reports. So I usually, for the most part, don't eat breakfast. I'm not a big fan of fasting, but I do kind of do intermittent fasting. I might fast for like 16 to 18 hours a day, which just means that I skip breakfast. I mean, I stop eating after dinner, fast through the night, fast through breakfast, and then I eat lunch. So that's kind of the routine that I'm going to try to follow this month. I'm not going to eat breakfast this morning. I plan on just eating lunch and dinner. So I'll show you what I have for those meals. And if I decide to have an afternoon snack, I'll share that with you. Okay, I did not make it very long this morning. My goal was to not eat anything until lunchtime, but it is only 9:30 and I am starving. One of my goals for this month is that I'm not tracking my food. I'm just listening to my body, and when I'm hungry, I'm gonna eat, and when I'm not hungry, I'm not gonna eat. So I'm starving, so I am going to eat. Here's what I'm having for lunch today. Actually, what I think I would call it maybe brunch. It's like not breakfast, it's not lunch, but anyway, here's my first meal of the day. 5 eggs. And I cooked these yesterday as part of my meal prep for the week. And basically I just took a muffin pan, sprayed it with some oil, cracked an egg into each one, and then I baked it for, I think it was 15 minutes, 15 to 20 minutes. At 350 Fahrenheit, and that's it. It's kind of like just a lazy way of making. I really like to have hard cooked eggs, or actually soft cooked eggs. I like the yolk to be soft, but this is kind of a shortcut way for me to do that. So basically they're just cooked eggs. Okay, I am sitting in my car. I forgot to mention earlier in the video that I have an appointment today. So I just got here. I'm a little bit early, so I have a few minutes to talk. So I know it's kind of weird that sometimes I do my videos up and down and sometimes across. And sometimes it's just easier for me to do the videos with them being up and down. So sorry if it looks weird, but so anyway, I have a doctor's appointment, and I didn't mention this when I did my year in review for last year. I kind of forgot about it, but so last month I had just my normal routine follow-up with my family doctor just to get my thyroid checked and my routine labs checked. And she was concerned that my white blood count was elevated. It's never been elevated before. And so I feel like it's probably related to my body's response, the inflammation from that giant fibroid that was growing in my body and my surgery and recovering from surgery. I don't know. I guess I'm not really that worried about it, but anyway, since it's elevated, she wanted me to see a specialist. So that's where I'm at right now. I'm gonna go see a specialist. We're gonna talk about my elevated white blood count. I'm guessing it's probably back down. I don't know. I don't know if they're gonna recheck my labs today or not, but anyway, that's what I'm doing right now. And so it's like 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So this was a crazy day. This was not a typical day for me because I had to fit this appointment into my day. So what happened is I have to drive an hour to get to my doctor appointment. So I had to leave work a little bit early today, which means that I'm going to have to work when I get home. but it also means that I didn't take a lunch break today. I just was like in work mode. I just wanted to get as much done as I could before I had to leave. So I didn't take a break for lunch. So I had those eggs that I showed you earlier at like 9:30 this morning. Sorry, I feel weird talking in my car sometimes. I feel like people are staring at me. But anyway, so I had the eggs and then I just was working. I was in work mode. I was drinking my coffee, drinking my water. Kind of lost track of time. And then before I knew it, it was like 2 o'clock and I had to leave for my appointment. So I was starving. So I was like, oh, I didn't make time to eat anything. So on the way out the door, I grabbed some things to eat. So on my drive here, I ate 2 Chomps meat sticks. This was a turkey one. I ate 2 of these. And then I ate 2 of these chunks of cheese, which this was the this was the wrapper. 2 pieces of cheese. So that was kind of my late lunch, I guess. So anyway, I ate those on the way here. And then I brought for the drive home, I brought a bag of pork rinds. These are the salted butter ones, which I love. They're so good. Sorry, like, I just feel like people are, you know, thinking, is she talking to herself? So anyway, I'm going to eat those on my way home after the appointment. I've got my water with my Relight electrolytes, pina colada flavor. I've drank a lot of water today. I've already had like 80 ounces of water, not including this one. So yeah, that's the pina colada electrolytes. I will have a discount link saved in my link tree down below for that if you want to try it. My discount code is just my first name, Stacy, Stacy. Okay, so anyway, that's it. I just wanted to touch base since I was early to my appointment and had a couple minutes. I think this car is gonna back into me. So anyway, I'm gonna go for now. Go to the appointment. Hopefully it's nothing major. And then I have an hour drive home. I'm going to eat my pork rinds on the way home. I imagine I'll probably eat something else when I get home. I think that person just hit someone. Or maybe they're gunshots. I'm not really sure what I hear. Anyway, I imagine I'll probably eat something else when I get home. Not sure what, but I'll let you know. Talk to you later. All right, I'm home. So my appointment went pretty well. She wasn't overly concerned. She thought there's a possibility that, you know, that elevated white blood count could maybe be related to my surgery and just my body's response. We are going to repeat some blood work in March. And she's also going to do some testing for allergies, autoimmune conditions, just to make sure there's nothing else going on. But she wasn't overly concerned, so I don't know, I'm okay with it, because all I know is right now I feel the best I have felt in so many months. I mean, it's so weird. It's like just this last week I've gotten, you know, to the point where I'm recovered from surgery, and
it's just all of a sudden I just feel really, really good. I have more energy than I've had in a long time. I feel good. So, except for my low back pain, if I could just get rid of that, I would be really happy. But anyway, just got home. It's around 5 o'clock. I need to go back to work because I did have to leave work early today for that appointment. So I have some stuff I need to get done yet. So I am still hungry. I am going to eat something else. It's making me a little bit crazy that I'm not tracking my food because I want to know how many grams of protein I've had today. I don't feel like I've really eaten that much today. And so I was kind of trying to figure it out in my head, like how much protein have I had? My concern is I just want to make sure I've had enough protein. I don't want to under eat protein. So, I am guessing, just doing it in my head, I think maybe like around 50 or 60 grams of protein. So, I mean, that's okay. That's like the bottom level, like that's the minimum of what I feel like I can have in a day. But I am gonna eat something else. I have some ground beef left over in the fridge. I cooked it yesterday. I had a taco bowl last night for dinner. And so I'm just having the rest of that ground meat. And I used, this is the taco seasoning that I use. And I don't know if you can read it or if it's backwards for you, but this is from Redmond's Real Salt. And it is just a really, really, really clean taco seasoning. And it's really good. So all I did is I cooked up a pound of ground beef last night, put some of that taco seasoning in there, put some salt in there, mixed it up. I topped it with some cheese and some sour cream, and then I cooked some slices of cheese in the microwave to the point where they were like burnt chips, and I had all of that together last night for a taco bowl. Well, I have a bowl of ground beef left over with the taco seasoning, and I'm just gonna eat it with a big blob of butter. It's like half a stick of butter because I'm craving butter. Like normally I eat a lot of butter anyway, and so I feel like I haven't really had enough fat today. I don't know, I'm trying to listen to my body, and that's what it's telling me. I need more fat. So I'm gonna eat the rest of this ground beef that's seasoned with that taco seasoning, and I'm gonna eat half a stick of butter. And that's gonna be my dinner. And I'm probably gonna just take that to my desk with me, and I'm going to eat that while I finish working for the night. So that's it, that was my day. And I feel like today, even though it was like a really just odd, crazy, unusual day, I feel like it was a good day because I feel really good. So it was a successful day one of my January challenge. Tomorrow, I feel like it's gonna go a little bit different. And that's only because we are taking Oakley to daycare tomorrow. And so we gotta go really early before work to drop him off and then, you know, go pick him up right after work. And so I'm not sure if I'm gonna have time to get my workout done in the morning tomorrow. It's all gonna depend on if I can get my lazy butt out of bed in the morning. I'm not a morning person, so hopefully I can get up early again tomorrow and I can have time to do my workout before we have to take him and before my workday starts. If that doesn't happen, then I'll probably have to wait until after we go pick him up after work, and then I'll probably have to do my workout tomorrow night. So, which I don't want to do that because I do not like to do my workout in the evening. Mainly because after a really long day of work and using my brain all day, I'm usually exhausted by the end of the day, and I just don't feel like exercising. But if that's what I gotta do, that's what I gotta do. So we'll see how tomorrow goes. But anyway, that was day one, and I will see you tomorrow.